Yeah.
Rap world gonna be canceled? Are we on the eve of the wokeness coming after hip hop? After the latest news out of the P. Diddy camp? And also, you wanna talk about other crazed rappers? Right now, the number one song in the US of A is a song by another crazy rapper that we all know and some of us hate, I guess, right? Tommy, do you hate him?
I don't really listen to music.
Kanye West, baby.
Got a little taser for you.
P. Diddy, yo!
Yeah, P. Diddy, yo! P. Diddler, yo, P. P. Diddler, P. Did, P. Diddler, P. Diddler, cause I'm P. Diddler for life, yo. Come on, Tommy, P. Diddler, P. Diddler, P. Did, P. Diddler, cause I'm P. Diddler for life, yo. Don't leave your kids with me, straight up. You'll see them later, sex detracting, make you reacting. P. Diddy's always all in the video, overreacting, yo. Way back in the day when I used to roll with Biggie, now Biggie's dead and I make money on my friend. My friend who's dead, you should've known I was a scumbag even back then. But now my name is P. Diddler. Leave your kids with me or her. I'm gonna P. Diddler. Maybe sex trafficking some kids today, throw them over the... Yo, I'm out on my plane, I'm going to Bermuda. You could raid my house and arrest both my sons and fuck my mouth. Yeah, I like penis, I didn't let anybody know. But yo, we flip the track every time we get the dough, yo. P. Diddler, Diddy, P. Diddler, Diddler, P. Diddler. Cause I'm P. Diddler for life, yo. P. Diddler. Touch your kids, touch this one. Sell this one on the black market. Cause I'm P. Diddler for life. Come on, Tommy. Tommy, how are you?
Doing good, man. How are you doing?
Hello, how the hell are you?
Doing good. Did I say? Oh, I'm sorry.
Tommy.
Taser for you.
Crazy shit going on in this world.
Most definitely.
The number one song in the U.S., like I said, is a song by the one and only Kanye West, ladies and gentlemen. It's the number one song in the U.S. right here. It is right here. Carnival by Kanye West. The number one song in the U.S. by crazed rapper Kanye West. Yo, Jewish people. Yo, you're not my equal. Yo, we be... Nah, I'm just kidding. But, yeah, this is the number one song in the U.S. right now, Tommy. Did you know that?
No, I don't really pay attention to this bad.
Yeah, I know. You don't really pay attention to the life around you. You know what I mean? But yeah,
yeah. I see your shots, Ken, and I'm bouncing off me.
You know what, Tommy? Listen, why don't you go drive on a bridge? Nah, I'm just kidding. But, Tommy, that's fucked up what happened. The bridge collapse. Everybody's been talking about it.
You know what amazes me when something terrible happens like this?
People blame it on, like,
the internet
just... right away. People go right to, you know, oh, it was a terrorist. Like, dude, it was weird. You got to admit, it was fucking weird how that boat.
I think it was an accident.
The video. Okay, I do too. But what I'm saying is, you got to admit, that boat, like, veering. The way it did, it looked like it veered into the bridge, like, as to, like we got to hit this bridge. Like, we must hit this bridge. Let's veer into it. You know what I mean? It was a little weird. A little, I don't know. I mean, was it an accident? I would say yes, it was an accident.
The company should pay for that bridge. Like, it was their, it, you know, it was an accident, but there was their ship. It hit it.
Well, look, you can see right there where the pylon was that got taken out on this map right here. And it was like that one pylon caused this entire fucking structure to just come down like a ton of bricks, man.
That right there scares the crap out of me from, like, going on a bridge. Like, and I have to go through a bridge just to go get through Jacksonville.
Well, let me tell you, man, I travel here in New York, and going in and out of Long Island, you go through the city, and there are some fucked up areas in the city where you're going under the Gothel's Bridge, you're going under the tunnels, you're going in, like, tunnels under the water, you're going into, you know, the Lincoln Tunnel, you're going into the Gothel's Bridge, which is, like, and there are some bridges that are, like, 500 years old here in New York, and this bridge was only, it was built in 1977, so it's only 46 years old, this bridge. It wasn't that old, Tommy.
Yeah.
And the way that this thing came down, it was pretty bad. It was pretty bad, just, you know?
Like, just collapsing. Like, there was nothing connecting it at all. It was just, woof.
Yeah.
And you're just like, people are still on that bridge, like, what they're going through.
Oh, you could see some of the workers that were on the bridge as the collapse happens, the video collapse. Yeah, it's pretty fucked up, man. We got the new view in, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you so much for everybody. For the last 2 weeks, I got a camera, and now I have the fixed camera view, which is below me. Is the fixed camera view, which I can basically put wherever I want in the room. It's a third camera now in the room. And I got this camera set up so we can look at what we're talking about, the whole deal. Have Tommy on here with his beautiful face. Tommy now down 51 pounds on the... Tommy's down 51 pounds. I'm down 53 pounds. Together we are down a human that P. Diddler could traffic, probably. A small human like that, I could see him grabbing at least 100 pounds.
And the fact is this somehow connected to Vince? And is it just some way...
No, you think somehow... This is tied into Vince McMahon?
Because he's been doing some human trafficking and some other shit. And
wait a second.
He has a lot of charges.
You're telling me that Vince was tied in with sex trafficking?
Yep.
Whoa.
You didn't hear about that?
I heard he was into, like, taking dumps on people and shit, but I didn't know he was into, like, sex trafficking.
Oh, yeah, like that.
Really?
Big time, apparently. Like, women and stuff like that, and just all sorts of weird shit. But I wonder, like, if this is actually P. Diddy that did this, or if someone's just trying to frame
No, they're saying, okay, so you want me to tell you everything that's involved here?
How?
Well, I'll explain to you in English. That's how. All right? So right here, they're showing you this video, first of all. I want to go over this video while we're looking at it. Do you see where we are right now? The ship is blowing out the black smoke. I think this was right after it shut off. On the video that you see, that's the best video that they have, I think, available so far. Yeah. There might be more videos coming out soon. Who knows? But the videos, the best videos that are available right now, show this boat. Like, with its lights off, like, floating dark. And I'm sure everybody has seen the videos already. I don't really need to explain. But here's some of the video right here. See, the lights are off on the boat right now. Nothing going on. But it already is kind of in a fucking peculiar spot already. You know, like, when it was first already going that way. Because the momentum is carrying this. And now... Well, look at this. This is the fucked up part that you're going to see here in a second. The lights come back on. You see dark plume of smoke come out of the engine, like, area, out of the, like, release area, right? And then all of a sudden you see this boat, like, beeline, really just turn its wheel towards the pylon on the bridge. Sure. That's what it looks like to me. Like... It just looks like you couldn't be any fucking more dumber behind the wheel of a vessel like this than this person was, because this is pretty fucking dumb. They cut their wheel. They dropped, supposedly they dropped anchor at this point as well, which really didn't do much, obviously. I mean, this vessel is that fucking heavy, you know, and here it is. Look, here it is. It turns right into it. It literally just like turns right into it. Why? I just don't get it. That's the part that where some people are like, oh, Ken, I'm telling you right now, it's the fix is in, bro. They meant to hit that fucking thing. And I'm like, bro, it was an accident. You could tell the boat was in distress. The lights went out. The plume of smoke comes out. I just, when I watched that last 3 seconds before this happens right here, which is utter catastrophe, and look at these cars passing by at the very last second. Little did they fucking realize, those people, and now probably watching these videos, they're saying to themselves, that was my car, because some of these people got over this bridge at the very last fucking second before this thing came tumbling down. And
that's my tractor trailer.
And let me tell you, man, I've had a reoccurring dream my entire life, right? And it's never a boat or anything like this. I mean, I have had boat dreams where I was on a boat and shit, but nothing like this, right? And here's the collision right now. You see that truck that just got over that bridge? Got over that bridge before this fucking idiot hits this pylon. And after that guy hits that, I mean, it's literally just four or five seconds, and this entire thing that probably took them months to build in the 70s. Just look at that last minute truck, I think that was, driving by. And look, you can't turn anymore to hit this thing. Like, you couldn't plan that better in a boat. You couldn't.
Hard to starboard.
Dude, you could not plan that better in a fucking boat than what that guy just did here, man.
Yeah.
I mean, come on, folks. Am I wrong here? I'm not saying this was done on purpose. But goddamn, this is one dumb, idiotic motherfucker that did this then, because, like, honestly, the way that they curled into it at the last second is just, like, beyond me. I don't understand how you can, like, you would keep going straight. Momentum is bringing you straight on the bridge. Like, momentum is bringing you straight in on the bridge. So, like, you're going straight in on the bridge. You're not, you, huh?
I'll be right back. I need to listen to something real quick. Okay? All right.
Yeah. So, like, momentum is bringing you into this bridge, like, not bringing you into this bridge. It's bringing you, like, parallel with the bridge at first in that video, right? And it looks like it makes a big, huge fucking turn to the right, like, almost like, yo, we got to hit this pylon. I just don't get it. I really don't get it. It really looks like the fucker, like, hit this pylon on purpose to me. Or, I mean, like, listen, he, you know, I don't know, man. I really don't know what to think. I really don't. Ladies and gentlemen, Tommy the Tart. Ladies and gentlemen, Tommy. Tommy Tart! No, I'm just fucking with you, dude. I'm fucking around because you have to leave every fucking time, dude. Fucking what? Stop!
What do you mean?
Did you take another screenshot, bro? Don't fucking do it. All right, so listen. So, like, for that guy to turn like he did, horrific. And let me tell you something. I understand why people are saying, yo, the fix is in, brother. I understand why some of these people are saying it. Now, when I heard the first person say that today, I said to myself, fucking idiot. But, you know, like, really studying that video, I don't know, man. Tommy, what do you think, bro? That's, I mean, are you taking a dump right now, or are we talking about a boat?
A ship, you mean?
A ship, Tommy. A shit, okay? A dump. A shit. A deuce.
I have to take a shit right now.
Okay, I figured that. You look kind of like you got to fucking take a human-sized fucking walrus dump right now, but okay.
You did take a shit earlier, and I could not have to do it again.
Tommy, I lost a couple more pounds than you. Don't be upset about it or jealous. Sorry.
Oh, come on. Thank you
very much.
Like, or just have a fair...
Nah, I'm just fucking with you.
Time to lose weight.
Like, you know I love you. You know I love you, brother. I always want, you know, like, I'm glad we're losing it at the same time, man. And we've been good, like, we've been together the same exact weight, like, this whole way through. In the 20s, in the 30s, in the 40s, and now in the 50s.
Because we put out the soda on our diet, didn't, you know,
well, just, I never really drank soda to begin with, but, yeah, we cut out a lot. You know what I mean? Like.
I was going to ask you a question. When you go to work, does the song I Woke Up This Morning, Got My
I play it every morning.
Gun?
Every morning on my way to work. But no, I don't want to see this guy. But yeah, so this bridge thing, man, like I said, I don't think it's not a terrorist attack. Like, you know, let me put up my hands and go like this. It's not a terrorist attack. Okay. But that guy looked like he deliberately turned into that vessel. If you're going to sit here and tell me he didn't, and he meant to, like, oh, he wanted to veer around that. It just doesn't look that way to me. I mean, Tommy, does it to you? You saw the video, right? Like, I mean, how do you explain this? How do you explain turning into that?
I think that they were trying to turn it, and then it were going too fast, and it was just in front of the pylon. I think that's what happened.
Yeah, but... What I'm saying is this. I understand what happened, Tommy. But what I'm saying is, why would you turn at the last second like he did? Because at first he was going straight with the boat, parallel The boat was going parallel with the bridge at first, like this, like kind of going towards it, but not at it. It was like it still had room in the middle of the bay. It turned at the last second. It literally just went like and fucking turned and... That was it. Like, that was it. It went right into the spot. It literally just directed itself into the spot, man. I just don't get it. And these poor workers, the guys who are busting their ass for shit probably over there, are the ones who got fucked the most because, like, they're out fixing potholes out on the fucking streets of this bridge when it went down.
Damn.
And it's a shame the whole entire Baltimore Orioles team was in a bus on the bridge. And they made it out. You believe that shit,
damn.
Tommy? Yeah, they made it out.
Damn.
Yep. Look at that, man. At night, look at the road, the way that the road is crumbled. Many of the people that live there were saying it's now the bridge to nowhere because there's literally a whole big part left right there. And if you can drive it, it's perfectly fine. And they say that, you know, people were on that road being stopped by cops. That would have probably just driven off the side of the fucking cliff that's there now. Which is crazy to think, because I can't tell you, like I was saying before, I've had dreams, reoccurring dreams, not of this, but like shit like this. And one of them is being on a plane and the plane crashing. But this is like one of those like horrible scenarios, like you're on a bridge, you're driving, you know, it's 1:30 in the morning, you know, most of the time I drive at that time, you know, those poor fuckers that were out like fixing potholes, bro, that is just, That's horrible, man. It really is. Look at that boat, dude. Like, look at that. It's crazy, man. Absolutely crazy. But this is the shit we see, you know? And people are saying, well, how can a whole bridge collapse like that right away? Like, how does a bridge just fucking come down like that?
This is a ship. This right here is a boat. Okay? Ship, boat. Definition.
Why? What makes
a boat,
Tommy?
You go fishing in, Ken.
What makes that a boat and not a ship?
Because if you look it up, the definition of ship, you can tell. You know, you go fishing on a boat. You enjoy yourself on a ship. Our cargo is hauled on a ship. There's a difference, Ken.
Thank you, Tommy.
And I'm not trying to be mean. I'm just saying that if you're a reporter and you're reporting something, it's better to say ship than boat. You know, I'm just saying.
Okay. Thank you for that.
No, I wasn't trying to, like, criticize you and say you were stupid or nothing. I was just wanting to help you out, bud, you know, because that's always what I want to do for you, bud. And you want to help me out.
I know. I help you out a lot, too, when you fuck up many words that you think mean one thing and then say the other. Like the other word I heard you explain the other day to somebody. I forgot who it was. You were explaining a word to somebody, and you totally – oh, it was what's his name that you do the show with?
Justin?
Yeah, you were explaining a word to him, and it was totally fucking not what the word means.
We're doing a show tomorrow at 8 p.m.
What about the show right now?
Okay. I always plug you on my show, man.
You know, plug YouTube, bro. Fuck this shit, dude. Nah, I'm just kidding. Go ahead. Plug it. Plug Tommy. Plug away, booby. Plug.
Tomorrow at 8 p.m., the Super Fun Time show is going to be happening. Tune on in. It's going to be a great time. Me and Justin having a great time. And I hope you can call in. We have hold on a second. I have the phone number we can use.
You phone fucker.
It's the phone number that you can call into the show right here. I don't know if you can see that.
Here's the phone fucker. The phone number, motherfucker.
But yeah, call on in and talk with us. Have
There's
a good
the mayor,
time.
Tommy, the mayor of Baltimore.
Oh, I love how the mayor, that one of the reporters asked the mayor, he said, well, how long will it take the bridge to be put back up? And he's like, that doesn't matter. What matters is the people that have been lost in this tragedy. Like,
Which is the right way to answer that. You know what I mean? Like, fuck how long the bridge is going to take. Fuck, like, all this other shit. Right now, the thing to concentrate on is anybody alive that we can find? Are we missed or anything? And that's the first thing you think about. Then you think about, you know, everything else, bro. You know what I mean? You think about everything else. Yo, you know who's inside of this lawsuit that P. Diddy's house and everything was raided about? You know who's inside this lawsuit, bro? The guy who's married to an American who's in the royal family.
Really?
You know the guy I'm talking about?
Oh, are you talking about Harry?
Yeah, dude, he's inside this lawsuit.
Oh my God!
Like, yeah, you know, man, I couldn't fucking believe it. I'm like, why?
Yeah,
but I'm like, why is this guy involved in this lawsuit? Why is he in it? You know what the fuck?
It's a conspiracy, man. They want to fuck up these people. They want to make up some charges on them. Like, it's all a conspiracy. They're just Harry's. This is the way the royal family would get back at him.
P. Diddy's house, numerous houses were raided, right? Look how they went there, bro. They went there in, like, straight up SWAT team fucking just, you know, because, listen, they think of P. Diddy as a gangster. That's what these law enforcement guys are thinking, that P. Diddy is gangster. That P. Diddy is, okay, you can laugh all you want, Tommy, okay? You can laugh all you want, but in reality, this motherfucker had power and was arrogant and treated people like utter shit unless you were somebody. That's how this dude was. He used to stomp on fucking people. There's a lot of people out there that are like that. Like that guy, Steve George Dropolis.
Your dog, probably.
Steve Droponopoulos, Phenopolopica, whatever the fuck his name is an asshole. That fucking guy who's on CBS. Oh, I can't stand that little midget. But
I
anyway.
Roseanne's on that list too.
Roseanne Barr?
No, I was joking. I'm saying that they're just targeting certain celebrities to ruin
their
image.
Listen. I think P. Diddy is guilty of a lot of the shit. I read some of the stuff of what he's being accused of because I'm like, what exactly is P. Diddy being accused of? And there are numerous. This is one of the women that are coming forward right now in this lawsuit and that are claiming all this crazy shit. Now, okay, we all remember how crazy R. Kelly was, right? Pissing on women, right? We all know how fucked up Vince McMahon was with shitting on chest and fucking, you know, these guys are doing sick shit, right? Supposedly P. Diddy was into, you ready for this? Supposedly P. Diddy was into snorting several Valiums, like a Valium type pill, and sucking big cock. Preferably,
ew.
Black cock. That's what it says in this article. Big cock. Big cock. Mark! You know what I mean? Like a fucking hung like Tommy NC 2010, 12 inches of fucking functified, just mental midget slab of meat. A fucking slab of mental midget hanging between his legs with more brain. Oh yeah, this is another guy, Cuba Gooding Jr. He's accused of fucking trafficking too. He's accused of the adrenal gland.
We're targeting celebrities and putting them on
lists. It's the adrenal gland, Tommy. Okay, I'm sorry, they're popular and they made movies. They're scumbags. Why do you think these people are being called out, bro? P. Diddy used to suck off fucking Usher. You know what he did?
Bro,
you know
how
what?
You
do you know what
if
P. Diddy?
Then...
Do you know what P. Diddy did to fucking Justin Bieber, bro?
No.
Okay, why don't you go fucking research it before you start saying, oh, they're just targeting celebrities now.
So you gotta bury me, Ken, because I'm just kinda,
I'm not burying you. All I'm saying is before you defend this guy and say they're just targeting celebrities, like some people are saying, it's out there, man. Fucking Justin Bieber was speaking about it numerous times about the, and even his mother was like, I have to get him the fuck away from this guy. I have to get my son away from this guy. You know,
the year
is 2024. And let me tell you something. Cat Williams, at the beginning of this year, when he did that interview on the Shay, yo, let me tell you something, man. It's this Shay. This is. This is the best podcast in the world because it's me. When he was on Shannon Sharpe's Skip, when he was on that podcast, right? And he said 2024 is going to be the year of truth, a year of reckoning for all these people in the entertainment industry. That doesn't mean just, you know, actors or actresses. No, that means everybody, singers, actors, all of them. It's all coming out. It's all coming out now, finally, because the atmosphere is so fucked up now. Anybody can make any claim against any Tom, Dick, or Harry if they really want. But a lot of people have claims put up against them. Not everybody has proof on it. There's proof in a lot of these cases that a lot of these people, like fucking P. Diddy, like Cuba Gooding Jr., have done. Just like they went and nabbed Donald Trump for. Because if you go listen to these people from NBC, CBS, they'll tell you, oh, Donald Trump was basically held liable for rape. Like, he raped somebody. And they're like, no, that was never proven in court of law that he raped somebody. And he was like, but he was held liable for rape. And they're like, yeah, okay, he was held liable in a lawsuit about an allegation of rape and slander and all this other shit that was involved in the case. And they were like, no, it was rape. And they're trying to, like, make it sound like he got convicted for rape, man. It's crazy, man, what's going on. And like I said, the funniest thing of it all is P. Diddy is over here jumping on planes the other day while his sons are being arrested at his house in Florida. His house in L.A. is being raided. And he's on a plane to Bermuda, trying to get the fuck out of town. He ditched out, man, and fucking left. And now his lawyers are saying, my client is innocent. They're on a witch hunt and all this stuff. They basically sound like you. So, but if you go look up what people are saying about this guy, his accuser in this case, in the specific case that he was raided for. And he's not just raided for just this one case. He was raided, Tommy, because he's been rumored to do crazy shit since the early 90s. You know, crazy, weird shit. But that's not why they raided him. They raided him because, you know, he's...
Do guilty people run? Yes. Do innocent people run?
Yes.
It's hard to say.
Yes, innocent people run sometimes. Yes, they do. Innocent people run sometimes. Listen, I saw this show that P. Diddy was on years ago. I think it was on MTV, right? Yeah. And it was like making the star. It was like making a star. So like he had all these different people on his program that were talented singers and dancers and all kinds of shit, right? He'd bring them into the studio. He'd have them sing and dance and do all this shit and show off their talents. And some of these people were unbelievably talented people. He would make these people go and walk to fucking Brooklyn from like the Bronx, which is like 20-something miles, to buy him a fucking cheesecake. And bring all the way back to his fucking place and not take a cab, don't take anything. You have to walk the whole thing. And he would have these people, just like talented people that were there to sing and dance and do shit. Even the people that were walking were saying into the camera, like, why are we walking to fucking Brooklyn for a cheesecake when we're here to sing and dance and to be rated on that? And like, what are we doing? And he would, and even like the show's producer at the time was like, what the fuck is this? Like, really, what is this guy doing? Like, this is stupid. And it really was. It was just like, you could tell he loved to like apply his authority on the people, you know? And you know what? Don't get me wrong. P. Diddy is an East Coast guy. And he was involved with that entire fucking West Coast, East Coast thing. And all that shit that went down with Biggie and Tupac. And all this shit. And he's from New York, so I have like a soft spot for him. But you know what, dude, this guy is such a evil, like vile prick that the shit that I read about him, if it is true, he deserves to be like just, he deserves to be taken as far as the law will take him. I'll say it that way. Now, Tommy, if you want to suck his cock, go right ahead.
Oh, thank you.
I don't know why you... But anyway, yeah, so that's the latest on him, man, you know? P. Diddy. P. Diddler.
Oh, and also in wrestling news, The Rock came out on Raw this past week and attacked Cody. Though didn't attack him at first. He whispered in his ear, said something to him. Then when Cody was in the back, he was attacked by the Bloodline. And then The Rock came at him, split his head open, and just kept beating the shit out of him. And I swear, I hope Mrs. Rhodes beats the shit out of him.
You must be getting, like, you must be getting so sick of this shit, because I know you were complaining about the Bloodline, even before they were the Bloodline. Like, you were complaining about...
Annoying. They're forcing Roman down our throat.
Yeah, well, I mean, a lot of people have been saying that, bro. They're like, you know, a lot of people have been saying he's like the modern-day John Cena. John Cena was compared...
I like John Cena.
Do you remember when John Cena... Look, they're showing fucking Prince, what's his name, to be involved in this lawsuit with P. Diddy. You believe that shit?
How typical... I think this is the royal family trying to fuck him over.
Dude, the royal family's got all kinds of fucking horrible shit going on. Everybody's got cancer. Everybody's fucking just, you know, I mean, it's crazy what's going on with these poor fucking people, dude.
The royal family is evil. They have some evil powers, and they do shit, and
well,
they killed their
own, you know what?
Member.
A lot of them were known for being involved with a lot of evil shit over the years. I'll agree with you on that. But I feel bad for that chick. I mean, she's a mother of, like, you know, three little kids. She's got cancer, you know, and I feel bad for the brother, the older brother of what's his name they just showed, Henry's older brother, because he's got his mom was killed, you know, and then, like, you know, all this shit happened to, like, his family. But anyway, these are highlights from Raw Monday night. The whole fucking storyline going off. What is WrestleMania 2 weeks away in Philadelphia?
Yeah.
Yeah, there it is right there, the sign from WrestleMania. 2 weeks away in Philly. A lot of people I know are going. Filthy is going, and he says he's taking me with him. And we're going, and we're getting tickets last minute. That's what he tells me. So
that's going to be nosebleed seats, dude.
I don't give a fuck where they are. I just want to make sure that I get to go.
Both nights, or are you just going to go one night?
I want to go to the Hall of Fame. That's all I know. I'd like to go the second night, to be honest, but I think he wants to go Saturday night. I'd rather go Sunday night. You know what I mean?
So that's the title match. That's the big title match.
What, Sunday night?
Yeah, Sunday night's the title match.
Yeah, Sunday night's going to be the big... There's going to be... Oh, shit. Sunday's going to be a lot of big fights on Sunday night, man. It's probably going to blow the fuck out of... Blow the shit away out of the Saturday night, you know? But look, here's Cody. Here's Cody and The Rock going at it right here on Monday night. And you know what? Listen, I don't know, man. I'm not impressed by this whole fucking thing. I don't know, man. I was all hopped up about 3 weeks ago on WrestleMania when they first changed the storyline. But now they just made The Rock such an evil son of a bitch again, you know? Like,
but then on social media, he's like, oh, I'm such a nice guy. Oh, look at me. Buy my skin products. And I'm like, dude, you're playing a heel. But then you're playing a face. Online, you're being like Dwayne Johnson, but then on TV, you're The Rock. Like, make up your mind. What are you going to be? You know,
Tommy,
like, it's weird.
Did you see the new bobblehead I got?
No, I did not.
So I haven't ordered a bobblehead in like 20 years, right? All these bobbleheads I just collected over the years, but I had to order this one because I was like, dude, I got to get this one because I knew the guy, right?
Yeah.
And he knew me and my family. So I was like, that was one. And number two, he scored the first goal to win the cup for the Islanders. Like, he scored the goal in overtime to win the Stanley Cup for the Islanders, their first cup. And I got Bobby Nystrom scoring the goal, the bobblehead version of it, with him holding his stick. You see this thing?
Yeah.
Oh, I fucking love it, Tommy.
Nice, man.
If I could, I would lick it.
Ew.
Shut up, dude, all right? This guy was putting fucking pennies in his ass, dude. And you know what he was saying, bro? He was going, you know, if you put pennies in your ass, you know, and the next time you see somebody, like if you do it for a really long time, he goes, the next time you see somebody and they intimidate you or anything, you ask them for some change. And if they give you a penny or something, just know that penny that person gave you probably was in your asshole. And now you have the upper hand on that person. And I was like, yo, what the actual fuck is going on here? Right? And I thought of you when I thought about it because of the whole fucking quarter thing, dude.
Yeah,
let
that die, can we? Just keep bringing it up.
I know, because it's such a fucking cool shock thing, man. You know, it's like,
never thought in a million years. Oh, my gosh. You know, everybody else would do shocking things, and then I say one thing.
Tommy, how do you like my new camera, Tommy? Come on, look. You ready?
It's cool.
Tommy! Now we got an over-the-shoulder bowl to hold the camera, Tommy. Look. You could see my overhead. You want to see my foreskin?
Oh, thank you.
Tommy, we got five cameras going at once. Yeah.
Hey, we have one camera and we just do different angles.
You know what, Tommy? I do multiple angles. And you know what? I'm getting ready for poker this summer. Because we're going to be doing poker during the spring and summer. And
now,
I want to...
Is this gonna be actual money poker? Or is this like...
Yeah, no. It's for points. You know what I mean? But it's going to be interesting because I have four cameras, right? Okay, so I had one camera... That worked. I had another camera that worked. They're good ones, right? And then I had this third camera, but it didn't work. And then I ordered this other camera that I thought wasn't cheap, but when I got it was cheap. And it's this camera right here that's shining now. It's kind of cheap, but it works good. And I set it up to be a fixed camera so it doesn't move around and blah, blah, blah a lot. This one I have on a tripod, but these cameras...
You're planning to stream these poker.
Yeah, I'm going to bring the cameras out there during the summer, and I'm going to set them up at certain spots, like under the table or over the table with a glass top table if I can do it, and you'll be able to see like the players' cards. You'll be able to see like what the drawer is, what the, you know, because we're playing Texas Hold'em. So you'll be able to see basically everything. There'll be one camera on the actual cards in the middle, you know, and all that shit. So, and on certain players, like people can watch my cards if they want. They can watch Filthy's cards if they want. They can watch two different.
Well, I hope it's not like Tony's gambling thing. I hope it's not like Tony's where you gamble so much that you're in so much fucking debt that you practically get the shit kicked out of
you. Who are you talking about?
Sopranos, like I just Tony's card games and stuff.
Oh,
like that.
Tony, you mean the executive game, right?
Yeah,
you're
going to
work the
executive.
Hey, I worked the executive game for you, Mrs. Soprano. You remember me? Yeah, I remember you. Yeah, I want to break my dick off in that dancer out there. You know what I mean? Tony, I should give you my half of that score from last week. You stupid fucking idiot! Don't talk to me in here.
Don't talk about business.
Don't talk about business in here. Get away from these people. They're Chuck Hopperkett.
I love it. Halfway into the season, he basically becomes the boss of the family.
I mean, by the end of the first season, he was basically boss, Tommy. You know what I mean? Come on. He's basically running Jersey. He went into his uncle and he grabbed him by the head and he went, I'll make you the boss, but you got to give me South Jersey, you cocksucker. Yo, they brought him out. Dude, The Rock brought this fucking guy outside and started throwing him up against buses and shit.
Yeah, that was his bus. That's Cody's bus right
Cody
there.
Cody rode his bus. So right after this, he goes right into the bus and gets his fucking little head taken care of so he can go in there and cry. My story. I want you to know my story. My story.
I'm for Cody. I'm for
you know what? I know. Everybody in their mothers for Cody, you know? Because the bloodline is a bunch of fucking scumbuckets. I can't stand any of them. You know what? I can't stand CM Punk either anymore, too, with this fucking little...
CM Punk. He's a fucking liar.
Stands there with his gray fucking beard. Like, get out of here, you old fucking fart.
And you break your arm the first night of the Royal Rumble. You get thrown out and you break your arm. What the fuck?
I know. It's like fucking pitiful, Tommy. Tommy, what do you say we take a social, Tommy? Social! It's a social, Tommy. Yeah. Let's go into the good old social box. It's the social box. Yes, it is. Oh, will the light turn on, Tommy, please? Hello, light. How are you? There you go. Now, Tommy, in the social box, we like to bring out one thing. His name is the Hermit Crab. He's the Hermit Crab because of his claws. And, Tommy, we don't have much of the Gorilla Glue, ladies and gentlemen. You can find it at your local distributor. Gorilla Glue. It's a piney, earthy type of green, and it's sleepy relaxation type of weed. Now, if I would have saw that when I first bought it, I would have said, go fuck you, but I didn't see it. So I want something that's going to like wake me up and get me going and make me want to be like a fucking midget, a mental midget. Sometimes I just want to be a mental midget.
I ain't no fucking mental midget.
Well, I am, so...
Are you fucking depressed, Christopher? I ain't no fucking mental midget.
Christopher, you ever think of, you know, bang yourself, you know? Oh, no, are you kidding me? I ain't no fucking mental midget.
I love that. That always made me laugh when he says that. I'm like, mental midget? What the fuck?
That's where I got it from, brother. That's why I started saying it in the community. Mental midget and mongoloid. Mongoloid was a big name my grandfather used to use with my friends. Like, whenever he would see Filthy. And Filthy would come over, and Filthy was like 500 pounds at this point. Filthy would come walking through the door like this, and my grandfather would go, look at this fucking mongoloid. And we'd all start dying laughing, man. Hey, all right, Tommy.
When did you decide to eat a salad, for God's sake?
Tommy, why don't you eat a fucking cock, for God's sake, all right? No, I'm just kidding. Listen, here we go. We're going to take a hit, Tommy, right now for you. Ladies and gentlemen, it's the first one of the night. Let's do an anti-social. As Jim Cornette would say, a henna henna henite. A henna henna henite. And a henna henna henna. And a henna henna. And a
henna henna. And a henna. If you don't like me, Tommy.
And a henna and a henna and a henna henna and a henna and a henna and a. He's a mental midget, okay?
I'm just going to say certain people would say, oh, yeah, Tom, you don't support me. I'm not ever going to talk to you. So out of support, I go and say some shitty thing to Jim Cornette. You know,
dude, Jim Cornette really is a fucking mental midget. I'm sorry. He really is, dude. He really is. Like, he knows. Okay, so I'll say this. He knows wrestling, right?
Yeah.
And he knows it great, and he is fucking unbelievable at, like, the shit he was involved with and the shit that he knows. He really isn't a match for a lot of other people, right, wrestling-wise.
Almost definitely. I met Jim Cornette.
Yeah, I remember.
It was really cool. He flipped me off.
But my point is, Tommy, he really, like, he's really fucking, like, retarded in a lot of ways, to be honest. But Tommy, did you see the new signs I got?
I think you were showing them to me.
Well, anyway, I don't think I showed them to the peeps at home. Here are the new signs that I got right here, which are my favorite. I'm only putting my favorite shit in that spot. Only my favorite shit. And the new ones, well, the original ones I had was the Masters of the Universe, He-Man, Back to the Future, Ghostbusters, and Contra. And that was like my favorite shit. I bought those first four. And then I was like, you know what? These are so cheap. I'm going to add them to the wall. So I got Halloween, which is one of my favorite franchises of all time. Caddyshack, one of my favorite movies. Do you like Caddyshack?
Oh, I love Caddyshack.
Yeah, I got Freddy.
Kunga or Kunga?
I got Nightmare on Elm Street. What do you think of that? You love it, right, Freddy? I got Smokey and the Bandit, which is one of my favorite movies of all time. I got the
FO ain't mean anything, Sheriff.
Tommy, I got the three. I fucked up. I got the Three Stooges, which I love, but it's the Three Stooges with Shemp, not Curly, who is my favorite. So now I got to get another one with Curly on it. But anyway, I got the Three Stooges. I got the Dukes of Hazzard.
Curly died at that point.
Tommy, the Dukes of Hazzard, which, come on. Did you ever watch them when you were little?
Yeah.
Did you ever watch Dukes or no?
Yeah, bits and pieces.
I fucking loved it. I loved it, bro. And then I got Punch-Out, Mike Tyson's Punch-Out.
Oh, jeez.
Right? And then the last one that's coming is Friday the 13th, Jason, like, with the mask on and everything. You know what I saw, bro, that was really cool, Tommy?
What?
It made me think of you and someone else that loves that shit. I saw the Jason mask, right? But it was every mask Jason has worn over the years, like on a picture frame. So it was like,
yeah. he's donned many versions of them.
Yeah. And you know which one, you know, which one was the shittiest?
What?
The one he wore when he was in like outer space that looked kind of weird.
Yeah,
that one is so fucking stupid, that one, man. It really is.
It was really stupid.
Can I tell you, listen to this. I had Shannon, right, the other night. I had Shannon on the couch with me, and I had control of the TV for the first time. Ow. Right, for the first time in a while, okay? And I had control of the TV, and I put the DVR on, and I saw, oh, shit, it's what movie was it again? It was Friday the 13th, right? Jason goes to Manhattan. Okay.
Oh God.
Now this
technically
is
technically Jason goes to Canada. That's where it was shot.
All right, but listen. So Shannon starts watching it, right? But she's not like paying full attention. She's into her phone and she's kind of looking up. And she goes, "Oh my God, what did you put on?" And I'm like, "Shannon, this is what I consider probably one of, if not the dumbest fucking Friday the 13th movie they've ever made." And she was like, what is this? Because she saw like the beginning of it where they're like on the boat, ship, whatever you want to call it, Tommy. What should I call it? Is it a boat or is it a ship, Tommy? But anyway.
This was a ship, and technically they were on a boat. in that movie.
God help me, God.
But Tommy, so listen.
God, please help me, because I'm just trying to help my friend.
Twat cream.
Tommy, so yeah. They're on this boat, and Shannon saw that they were on a boat, and she saw that he killed this guy on the boat, and it was pretty lame, too. And she was like, what the fuck? Where are they doing? What are they doing? And I was like, Shannon, they are going to Manhattan. And she's like, what is this one? And I'm like, this is Jason Goes to Manhattan. And she's like, I've never heard of it, never seen it, didn't even know it existed. And I was like, I couldn't believe she didn't know about it. She didn't even know.
One shot that they shot.
She didn't even know, bro. She had no clue that this movie even existed. And we started watching it, and we got far into the movie, almost to the end. And she was like, this is the dumbest movie ever. And I'm like, yeah, well, if you think this is dumb, you should check out Jason in Space. Because that is a pretty dumb one. That is a pretty dumb bad one. You know what I mean?
Which
one do you think is worse? Jason Goes to Manhattan or Jason in Space?
Jason in Space. It was bad.
Yeah, that was, man. I agree. One more social right here. Let's do it right now.
My mom had never seen Dumb and Dumber. Like, I sat her down the other night and just put it on, and she watched it. And she's like, oh my gosh, this movie is so stupid but funny at the same time. And that was the first time she actually sat down and watched that
movie.
Yeah,
you know, what's his name's in it? What's his name who plays alongside Jim Carrey?
Jeff Daniels.
Now, don't forget, Jeff Daniels was in movies like fucking...
Arachnophobia?
Yeah, but he also was in movies where he was like an actor's actor. Like, he had to really act big time. Like, big time acting. And when he first took that part of Lloyd, right?
Yeah. Lloyd.
He was a little intimidated because he had Jim Carrey. And
no,
Jim
Harry.
Carrey. Harry, I'm sorry, right. And Jim Carrey.
Harry, buddy, old pal.
Jim Carrey just came off of, I think, Ace Ventura.
Yeah.
And he was really, like, intimidated by the fact that he had to, you know, keep up with this guy. And he did. He did a great job because his character was fucking pretty funny. But, you know, I always thought of him as an actor. And I always was like, you know what? I thought of a million other people that could have probably played that role a million times better, to be honest.
Well, the thing is, he said when he got into the role that he had to shake his head, literally, just to get in that guy's mindset, basically.
Oh, yeah, he had to shake his head and, like, go, and act like, yeah.
Yeah, just, like, just to get
That's
him.
So dumb, though, man. You want, you got to rattle your brain so you think stupid. I have to rattle my brain so I think stupidly. I'm done now.
I think it's crazy that you shit on something like that.
I don't know.
Like,
it's like, I don't know. It's method acting. Like, some of these guys take method acting so fucking serious, but I do admire some of these method actors, you know? Yeah. You know. Hey, look, there's Galeen, bro. Your homegirl, Galeen Maxwell. Hi, Galeen. How them tatas doing, girl, in jail? How's the soap doing in jail, girl? Don't drop the soap. Does it count for girls? Don't drop the soap. There's the one of the chicks that are making the claims against P. Diddler. Oh my God, Tommy just dropped out of the P. Diddler. Tommy, you're not in the P. Diddles no more with us. There he is, R. Kelly. R. fucking Kelly, man. Fucking R. Kelly, man. That's another guy. I don't know what happened to Tommy. I don't know. Let me go see. Who knows?
Hello,
what happened, bro?
Called me, so I had to answer the phone.
Oh, yeah?
Just want to talk to me. We always do, like, a call around 9 o'clock and talk with each other.
Do you want to go? Do you want to go?
I talked to her, but, you know, also I'm getting pretty tired. I worked out this morning, and I always get really tired after I work out, but you know, I'll try to stay as long as I can, then I have to jump.
Yeah,
off
I'm not
here.
Staying on all night. I just came on just to wanted to talk about the bridge thing and, you know, P. Diddy, the diddler.
You know, it's crazy that we live in a world where social dynamics direct it to make fun of people. Like, we don't build people, we tear them down. And like,
well, that's how our society is, man, for the most part, you know, like
it's really fucking
it is, it is, but it's like, honestly, the people that should be teared down deserve it, and then the people that don't, and they deserve praise and they deserve good shit, you know, they deserve good shit, but you know, it's like it doesn't always end up evenly.
What do you know? Think about people like Tim Allen that just simply was just supporting a certain political party, and then he just got fired because he had the best rating show on that channel?
Well, I mean, what do you think of Roseanne Barr and what happened with her and the whole fucking thing on how she got taken out?
And then everybody got pissed at her. Like, she made a fucking joke, and then like, but if a black artist or a black actor would say something like that, oh, they wouldn't do a fucking thing. But if
well, I mean,
white
dude,
person...
dude, look at fucking what's his name, Jimmy Kimmel, right? The fucking guy was hosting the awards and shit, and meanwhile he had blackface and did all these fucking different skits and shit in blackface, and like, you're like, man, that's not fucking like they crucified other people for that shit, and now they're just gonna let this guy get away with it, and he sits there virtual. Like, you know, acting like he's better than everybody and like, you know, basically saying, oh, you know, you should do this and you should say that. You should be this and you should be that.
He's absolutely.
I can't stand the fucking guy, bro. He is the worst, man.
Absolute shit. And I tell you
absolutely.
What, I'm going to make it good in 2024.
He's absolutely a horrible person. Screw him, his family. And you know what? I'm glad the judge in the case with Trump, turned around and let Trump pay 100 and something million as opposed to like 300 and something million. Tommy, what do you think of R. Kelly, Tommy?
I have no opinion on him. I don't listen to his music, really.
I just want to pee pee all up on your fucking face, baby, human fucking waste. I'm peeing in your face. Let me get up in the elevator. We're going to do it later. Tommy, pee pee and give me some poo poo. Rubbing some shit on your face, bouncing on your face as we at this. Remix to ignition, hot and fresh out the kitchen. Got a big deuce, baby, and it's waiting for you in the kitchen. Took a shit in the stove, I got shit in the fridge. Waiting on you to fucking show me the fridge. Yeah, me and Vince McMahon be rolling and rolling. Vince, come on in and sing too, Vince, come on. You know I'm not trying to be rude, but hey, I'm gonna take a shit on you. And it... Nah, Vince, get the fuck out of here, man. Get out of here, man. I want to take a pee-pee, and Vince want to take a poo-poo. Together we going to do number 1-1 and number 2-2. Tommy, you know what to do when you get them quarters inside you. I don't want to make you do. So give
you
me
know,
some
I
poo.
I think Vince did that shit. I think Vince is a scumbag. Like,
give me some poo-poo and some pee-pee. Put some poo-poo on your chest. Rubbing some shit on your breast. Rubbing some, Tommy, rubbing some poo-poo on your chest, rubbing some shit in your chest.
I'm not no kid.
You're fired.
Have a good night, buddy.
Tommy, why you gotta be a dick, dude? Have a good night, brother.
Tired, dude, okay?
What?
I'm tired.
I know, but like, you don't even give me a warning. You're like, just, Kelly, have a good... I have sleep apnea again. Mark!
Like, fuck off, Ken. I gave you my best, man. Dude.
You know what? You didn't. You never give me your best, bro.
Fuck you, Ken.
You never. Tommy, don't do that to me, Tommy. That's rude, bro.
Bub.
That's rude, bub.
Bub.
That's not rude.
You're a rude bub.
And tell your lovely wife, Shen, I said hello.
You know what, Tommy?
Bub.
I'll see you later, Tomza.
First thing I also want to do for you, Ken, hold on.
Too cool for school with Tommy. We're not cool enough for the Tomza anymore. You motherless motherfucker!
Bye-bye, Ken!
Bro!
Bro!
tuna.
Tommy, you know, son of a bitch took a fucking screen scrot at the end of the fucking stream. He takes a screen scrot. Fucking guy takes a screen scrot.
You fat.
Oh, come on now, dude. Oh, come on now, bro. It's remixed to Ignition, bro. It's hot and fresh out the kitchen. You know what I mean? It's hot and fresh out the kitchen.
You fat retard.
This is that new shit right here. Sweeping the nation. Sweeping the nation. The foul mouth nation. The first champion. The people's champion.
Diddler for life, he's P. Diddy, he did. P. Diddler, innocent, proven guilty, till proven guilty, cause he's P. Diddler for life, yo, P. Diddle. Diddly Diddler, P. Diddler, Diddler, P. Diddler, P. Diddler for life, yo. My name is P. Diddy and leave your kids with me. Sex trafficking drugs, bitches we see. Yeah, we selling them all. I'm dancing in your video right in front of y'all. Yeah, that's how P. Diddy fucking do it. They came to my house with a whole fucking army just to bust my sons while I was on a plane to Bermuda, son. Yeah, P. Did. P. Diddler. Diddler. P. Diddler. He once dated J-Lo, ho. P. Diddler for life, P. Did. P. Diddler, 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 did. P. Diddler, cause he's P. Diddler for life. Yo, leave your kids around me. 1, 2, 3, you'll never see them again. Yeah, we fencing them. We selling them. We on the black market with them. Your kids are gone, son. I'm P. Diddler. I jump inside my private jet and I straight see ya. Here's all the shit you need. Go fly to Bermuda and fucking dig it 3 feet deep and bury all that shit. Cause I'm P. Diddler and shit. Yo, P. Diddy. P. Diddler, I'm the diddiest motherfucker you ever seen. FBI can't do shit to me. They raid my house, but y'all motherfuckers can't see me. Like John Cena's old ass. You can't see me, you white piece of trash, P. Diddy. Diddler, P. Diddler, P. Diddler, P. Diddler, cause I'm P. Diddler for life, yo, P. Did. P. Did's not guilty, P. did nothing, P. did something. Oh, P's gonna get in trouble for something, cause he's P. Diddler for life, P. Diddler. P. Diddler, P. Diddler, P. Diddler, P. Diddler.
Yo, his name is P. Diddler, he touches little things and little kids and things, P. Diddler. Banging things, making motherfuckers go and get them cake and shit. P. Diddler, he thinks he's better than everybody else. They raided his house with a fucking army. Yeah, you can't see me, man, his army. Come through his front door to raise both of his sons. P. Diddler, P. Diddler, P. Diddler. The P. Diddy man himself. Did he do it, or is he innocent? Did he do it, diddly, did he do it? P. Diddler. P. Diddler, cause he's P. Diddler for life, P. Diddler, P. Diddler, 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 cause he's P. Diddler for life, yeah, P. Diddler, P. Diddler, P. Diddler. For life, you fucking fuck Jews, motherfucker.
You caused some fucking chaos in the community. You caused some fucking chaos in the community.
Chaos in the community. What?
With here. I'm for that gang gang lol.
Shout out to everybody out there, baby. Have a good night, everybody, on a Wednesday night.
On a Wednesday, Monday, Tuesday. And you can't forget about Wednesday. Oh God, Wednesday is hump day. Oh God. It's a Wednesday. Hump day. Oh God.
Okay.
Gotta learn shit the fucking hard way.
We're fighting for our lives.
They're fighting for our lives. They're fighting for our lives. They're fighting for our lives.
42.
I will bend for you. I will bend for you. I will bend for you.
3, 1, go! 42.
I will bend for you.
I will bend for your cock. That's what they said to the great P. Diddy, otherwise known as the late great P. Diddler, ladies and gentlemen. The late great P. Diddler, otherwise known as AKA Sean Puffy Combs, P. Cone, P. Comb, P. Diddy Combs, P. Double Diddy Diddy Drop, P. Double R to the D O Double G, P. Squizzit, P. Shizzy, P. Shiznitz, P. Squizzle, P. Snot Snitzno, P. Schnitzel when he was in his Jewish phase, Peener Wiener Schnitzel, Peener got Wiener Wiener Beener, and also Peener the Wiener Eener. Peener the Weeder, the Wiener Eater, they used to call him. That was Usher. Usher used to call him Peter the Weeder Eater. He used to eat wood.
That's right. P. Diddy gonna eat your wood, baby. Come on. P. Diddy gonna eat your wood now, baby. P. Diddy gonna eat your wood now. P. Diddy like the motherfucking wood now, baby. P. Diddy like the wood now. P. Diddy will bend for you.
I will bend for you.
Diddy will bend for you now. P. Diddy will bend
for you. I will bend for you.
I'm gonna bend for you.
I will bend for you.
I'm gonna bend for you.
I will bend for you.
Bend on bend for you.
I will bend for you.
I'm gonna bend for you.
They're fighting for our lives.
I will bend for you.
They're fighting for our lives.
I will bend for you.
I'm gonna bend for you. 42 for you.
42.
And then a 2 plus 2. And then something on 2.
Get a 50-pound bag of penis from the penis. Penis, weenus, I like to suck a big penis. Yo, late night, in the middle of the night, I'm just creeping. Yo, P. Diddy eating. Penis, we creeping. Yeah, I see a penis, I'm eating. Yeah, fuck that, next time I'm creaming on a dude's semen. Yeah, you can call me a mate. Motherfucker, I'll see you around Watergate around 8. Fuck that, fuck me so hard in the butt crack. I lost my sunglasses in the butt crack of the morning. Pancakes while I'm yawning. Yeah, straight up while I'm getting dipped out of your wife. Bitch made me into a dyke. Be liking girls, but now I like men's. Yo, Jenny Lopez, let's fuck again. See you around four while I fuck your friend. Yeah, it's all about the kids. Well, we take them to the border, and then we make them jump the border and go somewhere else. And we sell them, and we make money for them. Yeah, around fucking 10 or 11 or 12 years old, we sell them at the border, yo. P. Diddler, P. Fiddler. The dude's better known as the Benjamin Killer. It's all about the cock, baby. All about the penis, baby. Yeah, uh-huh, yeah, it's all about the pee-pee, baby. Uh-huh, yeah, that's all about, yeah. It's all about the penis now, baby. Yeah, uh-huh, yeah, it's all about the, even in this photo, it's all about the penis. Even in this photo, I was thinking, man, I want some penis. It's all about the penis in this photo. Yeah, she was like, oh my God, I can't believe I'm here with him. And the whole time he was like, penis, uh-huh, yeah, penis, yeah, uh-huh, yeah. Penis, uh-huh, yeah, P. Diddy, P. Hizzy, P. Shizzle, P. Dizzle off the hizzle for rizzle, yeah, P. got a big old dizzle, and he likes sucking the greasy and the grizzle, yeah, P.'s exquisite with his hizzle, P.'s hips are swizzle, you know what I mean, P. drops the fucking soap in the shower, takes about an hour, killing children in the shower, takes about 1 hour. When I let the Benjamins, baby, it's all about the five pieces from the mutts. Five carrots, the bird with the clutch. I want it all chromed out, rest of the wrong figure. Bone the bone with ya, I got a bone dildo. It's golden, and you know we wanna roll it. Straight up in the room, so Usher gotta feel it. Yo, Justin Bieber, come in with the sleeper. I put you in the bed and I start to fucking eat ya. Ha! Dip it the Benjamins, uh-huh, yeah. It's all about the penis now, it's all about the penis now, baby, uh-huh, yeah, it's all about the pee-pee now, uh-huh, come on, Justin, beat the penis now, baby, uh-huh, yeah, it's about the penis now, baby, P. Diddler, come on, baby, uh-huh, yeah, P. Diddler, yeah, that's right, Usher, dancing around at the Super Bowl, when you know your asshole was on Super Swole, when I got done with it, you couldn't dance around, now you can't even open up your mouth and act like a clown. You got fucked before you even signed a contract. You knew it, cause I had my dick inside the line of your jacket. When you walked out, now you talked out. I put cum in your big mouth. Now you're dancing all around and you got the hole. Everybody looking at you at the Super Bowl. And you fucking think that you are so cool. But meanwhile, I fucked you, dude. Yeah. That's so fucked up. Hey, that's what Usher said. I mean, Justin Bieber said. It's all about P. Diddy now, baby, uh-huh, yeah, it's all about P. Diddy now, yeah, uh-huh, it's all about P. Diddy now, P-42-D, yeah, it's all about the P. Diddy's now, uh-huh, yeah, uh-huh, uh-huh, hide your wife and hide your kids, uh-huh, uh-huh, yeah, it's all about P. Diddy now, baby, uh-huh. It's all about the P. Diddy now, baby. Uh-huh. Yeah. Oh, poor P. Diddy. You know, I don't know. The stories I hear, I can't feel bad for the guy. I just can't feel bad for this guy who's lived a life of lap of luxury and lives other people's life in misery. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you so much for listening tonight on this version of Canon.
Yeah. Shout out to the one and only Foul Mouth Cheddar. Everybody have a good rest of your week. And we'll see you soon. God bless everybody. Have a good rest of your week. God be with you guys. See you guys soon. Peace.
Yo, yo, pee, Diddy like the pee-pee and the pee-pee go caca. And when he do the pee-pee and the pee-pee and the mama. Yeah, pee-pee and the caca with the pee-pee mama. What you want, you better put the pee-pee and your mama. I don't want no pee-pee with your pee-pee and your drama. I don't want the drama, plus your pee-pee and your mama. You can talk a shit and I'll tell you what you wanna. I don't talk a shit when I eat marijuana.
Potomato, Potomato mentality. They say to get the beta from Bernie Madoff. They made Manny Madoff, but they made Trump pay more than Bernie Madoff. What a bullshit.